Good morning, Kishwaukee Bible Church. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Yes, he is risen indeed. We just are so grateful to share this moment with you. Brothers and sisters in the Lord Jesus at Kishwaukee Bible Church, we're celebrating Easter, the resurrection of our Lord Jesus. And wow, there's so much to talk about and so little time, but we just want to just share our hearts with what's been going on a little bit in our lives, and then also how this weekend, Good Friday, and today are affecting us. So
for me, life has been pretty much as normal, mm-hmm. Except for no people, virtual people. Mm-hmm. So sewing, gardening, a lot of things like that are still pretty much the same. Reading and trying to relax a little bit more and spending more time with the Lord as He is helping us to be still before Him. But one thing that really struck me in the beginning of all this was Corrie Ten Boom in The Hiding Place and how things changed overnight for her and how it is for us too with this COVID virus that's so deadly. And she said that when, we don't know where we're going, we don't know where all this is headed, but she said that the Father will give us the ticket at the right time, will tell us where to go and when to go. So that to me was something that's kind of stuck out. The other thing is just how much we take for granted that I'm hoping we'll appreciate more when this is all over, being able to meet together and Bible studies and grocery store and all those things that are normal, playing, the kids playing outside together, all those things. I think we're going to appreciate them. I mean, I will all the more. But a couple of songs that go through my head, because I have playlists going through my head.
You have playlists, yes.
There's two songs, and one of them is something we haven't sang for a while. And it is the one that is, let me grab my paper because I can read it. It is, I Will Be Still, and it's based on Psalm 46. And it says, I will be still, I will be still, I will be still and know that you are God. I will be still, I will be still, I will be still again. And then it goes through this list, and after each sentence it says, I will be still. Though the waters roar and the valleys quake and the mountains fall and the earth gives way, though the armies war and the nations rage and the kingdoms fall, and the earth will melt. It just continues with, I will be still after each of those statements. So that's a big one. And I think God has us still right now. He has made us be still before Him. Mm-hmm. And I want to do that. I want to be still before Him. And the other one is, It Is Well With My Soul. And that one is just, to me, is a big one. Because through it all, my eyes are on you. Through it all, it is well. It is well with my soul. And I just, that is a big one for me, that I just remember that it is well with my soul because I have hope in His resurrection and in the work He has done. My soul is well. So,
very good.
You, Jim?
Yeah, that's awesome, Jeanette. I just been keeping busy, helping people save some big money in the mornings, a few mornings a week. I've also been doing a little gardening, but I've been connecting too more and more electronically with my mm-hmm. brothers in Christ at KBC, and it's been a joy to do that. You know, I miss having coffee with my KBC homies, but it's nice to have the electronic thing to do as well. One thing that's really been on my heart, it's really struck me this Easter season, especially this weekend, Good Friday and today, is how much like what we're doing today and what we did Friday are so much like the very, very first Passover way back in Moses' time. I mean, we're talking way, way back. Think of the similarities. We are in our homes because of this virus, a deadly virus, and the Israelites were commanded to stay indoors lest the death angel slaughter their firstborn. But also they had to they were commanded to have a special meal. And in that meal they slaughtered a lamb, and the blood of that lamb was on their doorposts to their homes. Well, Jesus at the Last Supper said His blood is the blood of the new covenant. We are saved by His blood, and that Last Supper was actually a Passover meal, was it not? Mm-hmm. So when we took communion on Friday night, I thought, wow, this is an amazing thing. And then when God allowed Moses to lead His people out of Egypt into freedom, Jesus leads us into freedom, not only away from our punishment of sin, but also into eternal life. Jesus has opened that door because of His resurrection, which we celebrate today. And that's what's been on my mind. I think
cool.
For me, that just really, wow, that struck me pretty good.
It's big stuff.
It's big stuff.
Yeah.
It's probably the biggest stuff I can think of.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, anyway, we just want to wish everybody happy Easter. And again, he is risen.
He is risen indeed.
And we're going to pray. We do thank you, Father God. You are such a good God. Not only you, Father, but the Son and the Holy Spirit. We just praise you, Lord, and thank you for the wonderful things that you do, but more importantly, the wonderful God that you are. And just we pray, Lord, that as we live for your Son, Jesus, that we would just lift him up high every day and your name would be magnified and that people would be drawn to you because what you are doing in our lives. And let us not shy away from those things, God. So be glorified. I just pray that you would be with Jesse today as he speaks truth through your word. And your word is truth. And we just pray, God, that you would just use him mightily and open our hearts and minds to receive those things and be joyful at the God that we serve. We praise you and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.